It's not easy being crafty in New Jersey these days. The state's Division of Alcoholic Beverage Control recently issued tough new rules on craft breweries. The regulations are wide-ranging and include limits on what brewers can serve, as well as the number of TVs they can have on site.
The ABC says the rules are fair and appropriate and strike a balance between the craft brewing industry and restaurants. But Baylen Linnekin says they're lousy. Baylen is a law professor at George Mason University, and he's the author of Biting the Hand That Feeds Us. Thank you for joining us, Baylen.
Thank you very much, and congratulations on the Raptors win last night.
I like how people are congratulating me like I was, you know, like I had something to do with it. I did buy a hat, and I do buy tickets on a regular basis. That's about it, but I'll take it. So listen, Baylen, you go beyond just calling this, like, lousy rules. You say that this is actually an affront to free speech and consumer choice. Why do you say that?
On the free speech angle, there's a cap on the number of events that a brewery can market during the year, and there's no rational reason for that. It's an impermissible restriction on the free speech rights of brewers to communicate what they're selling. And then as far as consumers go, it's ridiculous. You can't, you know, breweries can't make food, so you either have to bring food with you, or you have to find some food truck that can't park on the brewery's lot under the regulations, and, you know, run off and get that. And obviously, we want people who are drinking to be eating as well, because that is the safer choice.
So, talk to us about some of the most restrictive rules.
For example, if you want to drink in a brewery in New Jersey, you, under the rules, need to first take a tour. And that might be a sort of, you know, rudimentary 15-minute thing, but that's a hassle. You want to go in, you want to show your friend, your, you know, significant other, this new brewery in town. You've got to do that. The brewery has to keep a record of it, and you have to do that at least once a year. So that's certainly one. The food truck restriction is another. It says that breweries can't work with food trucks or vice versa to promote that. They can't serve food. I think one of the few foods they can serve is water, which is silly. And so those are a couple. There's the marketing restriction, which I mentioned. You know, all in all, this really adds up to protectionism, and it's not a... It's a terrible approach to trying to foster an important growing industry such as the craft beer industry.
I find this interesting because I think in other places, and I think about Pennsylvania, and I could be wrong, but in order to serve alcohol, you must have food. You know, sometimes you go into bars and all they have is sort of a bag of chips and a dying hot dog on a wheel, but in order to serve alcohol, they have to have food. So this seems sort of counterintuitive. Explain to us exactly what the ABC is concerned about. Why are they doing this at all?
Well, there's a 2012 law in New Jersey which really helped foster the growth of the craft beer industry, and that was a good thing. But the department decided, the ABC decided, that they needed to write rules. Well, they were asked to write rules, and they have, but those rules basically misinterpret the law, which was intended to, you know, benefit the craft beer industry and consumers in a way that basically they've made this industry beholden to, amongst other things, New Jersey's restaurant industry, which is really, you know, they're regulated by the same ABC in terms of alcohol sales. So you've got this department that's basically picking favorites of whom it regulates. And obviously the restaurant industry is much more powerful than the nascent craft brewing industry in New Jersey. And so, you know, the craft beer industry gets the short end of that stick, and that's unfair, and it's wrong, and at least in the case of the marketing restrictions, it's probably unconstitutional.
Do other states have similar restrictions on craft breweries?
My follow-up column this week, I'm talking about other restrictions. Every state has bad craft beer laws in some respect. They're usually getting better. And, you know, I think I applaud states that are stepping up their game in terms of deregulating in a way that fosters competition and choice for everyone. But, you know, every state has at least one bad craft beer or beer law in the books. And they vary, as you note. You know, Pennsylvania has some rules that, you know, that require food. New Jersey prohibits it. You know, why not? Here's an idea. Why not let the breweries themselves choose if they want to sell food or not? and let consumers choose if they want to frequent breweries that have food or that don't.
So
it's not that difficult.
I'm still sort of confused as to why all these rules. Is there a concern that if the craft brewery industry starts to boom, it's going to have a negative impact on the restaurant industry, that people won't go to restaurants as often because they'll have this other choice?
Parsing the language of this special ruling by the New Jersey ABC, I think that's their concern. I think it's a ridiculous concern. I'm talking to you right now from Washington State, Seattle specifically, and you know, you can't throw a rock here without hitting a brewery. Not that I'd recommend throwing rocks at breweries. But you know, they're very welcoming of breweries, and yet you know, Seattle has a ton of breweries and restaurants, and they thrive together and they actually work together. And you know, there are plenty of breweries that serve food. There are others. There's one down the street that just has pretzels and apples. But you know, they have the choice, and that's really what you know, what's great for everyone. And you know, the breweries here, just as they do in New Jersey, often sell their beer to local restaurants. It's really a symbiotic relationship, and New Jersey's treating it like something entirely else, like a problem that needs to be solved. When they're the ones creating the problem.
And go ahead.
Yeah, I was going to say, so what are the New Jersey Brewers Association saying? What are they saying about the rules?
So they don't like the rules, but they're applauding the ABC, you know, as I guess, you know, we applaud people who regulate us, and saying that they're going to work with the legislature to try to amend the law. They do, you know, the proposed rules from 2018, from last fall, were lousier. And so the New Jersey Brewers Association is basically saying, you know, thank you for not adopting those really terrible rules. We'll work with the legislature to change these. But you know, I think they're in a bit of a bind. You know, they're up against a powerful regulatory body and a powerful restaurant industry. And so you know, I certainly can't speak for them, but based on what they've said and what they told me, you know, they're happy that it's not as bad as it could be, but hope that it gets better soon.
Really interesting stuff. Baylen, thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Cheers. Thanks so much.